How the a house would get the solar energy into temperature change in the ground? This is the earth. And then suppose this place, Kaiwaka, gets 0 degrees in winter and 30 degrees in summer. Then if you go down 8 meters below the surface, you will find the average. That means 15 degrees. If the house is on the ground, it's deviate 0 to 30 degrees outside the temperature. So here in this local area in New Zealand, then if you lift up your house above, now not directly affected from the ground, then you have to make a thermal insulation here and then try to get the solar energy in the house. Dig a little bit hole, that means the basement, and then we call it a cool tube. The purpose of the tube is to have an exchange of heat from the ground. Say now we think about the summertime, hot air. Then coming, here is the rain protection and just the concrete pipe. At my house, it has 10 meters long and then 3.2 meters deep. Here is a solar room which collects solar energy. This side is thermal insulated. Sunny side is a double glazed glass. And then here is a chimney letting the hot air in the solar room run away to the air.
You can have this kind of room in the same level next to the house.
Like a veranda.
Conservatory, like.
Of course, we need ventilation holes to letting the inside air moving through. And the ground floor also has such an hole. Now, this room temperature is risen with the direct sun, solar energy, then it's very hot. So then hotter, the more lighter air runs through the pipe. If the outside is become hotter, then more air runs away. That means more cooled air coming through the house. If the air is cooler, then you can take in to the house. You put certain reflection material outside the wall surface, south in New Zealand and north in Europe. But outside walls are clay finished. Heat storage is nice. The latitude of the place is higher, that means sun. Very low angle coming. They need more area. So if it is latitude is low, energy comes a lot. But if sun comes like this, this area should be expanded here. So I'm doing experiments at this latitude. So if you go to north, then you have to expand your land wider to collect the solar energy. It's in a very coarse expression, but that wide land, you have to try to get the solar energy, like a planting of trees or all sort of energy activity you have to do there. If this is a whitish or silverish, then negative reflection goes away. But if it is absorptive of radiation, this surface itself decreases the temperature. This is the case, the solar radiation is positive, and it's reflect. And it has a little bit of thermal insulation behind. But I put this one over the styrofoam. And then this is made and come over. This is precisely cut. This is the window of my study and the bedroom. And then I put this one like this. Not much expect you can have, but even tiny bit. And then thermal insulation is given. The glass is thermal conductive. And then already this wall has an air gap. So thermal insulation is much better than this. And then even the noise insulation kills the weakest part. So this is the really weakest part in this room. So this is very efficient to give it to. And thermal insulation, concrete wall is already rigid, but window is very weak. So double it, double glazed, then thermal insulation is all right. In the winter, I close at the bottom. Then solar room gets heated up. The highest spot in the solar room is here. So I put the electrical fan at the top of this air duct, which runs from there to the beneath the ground floor. And then it's distributed beneath the ground floor, having six branches. Beneath the ground floor, coming back to the solar room, and again heated up by the sun, and then it's taken down. So this going down and going up cancels the pressure. Only the resistance loss is supplied by the electrical fan. Not much consumption. The sensor, if it tells above 20 degrees up here, the fan start to operate, to be operated. And then it's coming down, down, and distributed from the branches. Room temperature in this living space is never below 10 degrees.